Hey guys, welcome to another episode of LJ's Garage, and behind me is a 2015 Lexus IS 250. So stay tuned, we're gonna find out if this car can give BMW a run for their money. Just a bit of information, this is the third generation, which is available from 2014 moving forward. And no, this is not your grandma's boring Lexus or anything like that. No offense, grandma. This is a sportier version of what Lexus used to be. And they did a redesign, and I'm actually pretty happy with the outcome. The first thing that I'm gonna point out and start with is the front end. Most of you guys have seen this driving around, so you've already become familiar with the new Lexus image. But I just wanna take a moment to point this out again and say how stylish this front end is. It's nice, aggressive, and it's sleek. I find this pretty interesting, but Lexus basically sealed their L logo in there. And so you can touch this. This isn't like an actual like badge that you can rip off. This is just like a sealed L, which is a little different than the way they used to do it. When it comes to daytime running lights and the cool LED trends that are going on in the industry, I like when auto manufacturers get really creative, and I like what they've done here. It's kind of similar to like the Nissan's boomerang headlight, but this is different in that it's just a little check, but it wraps around the side of the body, which accentuates the body lines of this gorgeous car. When this first came out, a lot of Lexus owners were like, this sucks. We don't want this on our car. But the younger buyers were like, I like this. And I'm one of those younger buyers. Good job, Lexus. As far as this one goes, it is the IS250. It's not the F Sport. If you guys have seen the F Sport, this one's got more aggressive styling. I'll put a picture of that up right here in this region somewhere. And but otherwise, this one's more of the sleek grown-up car. So it's got good looks, but it's not aggressive. It's got cool wheels, but they're not overly sporty. It's just a good-looking car. All right, I'm good. I got all snot out. Even though this one is a 2015 and it's basically like the entry Lexus, you do get a lot of the standard things that you get from most luxury brands like keyless entry. And this is your little Lexus key. There's not really a whole lot to it, just your standard key. As we're working our way around this car, I'm gonna pause right here because this is cool. They basically started their taillight right here and it just wraps all the way around. And you don't see that very often, and you see it on their like Lexus sports cars like the ISF and all of those higher end models, but they put it on their IS250 and it looks so good. On the back end, it's nice and simple, but so clean. They've got this lip spoiler, which isn't aggressive by any means. And then this Lexus badge, different from the front, see this one is three-dimensional and you can actually like grab the L. The last thing I'm gonna point out back here, you've got dual exhaust tips. Now this is the 2.5 liter, so it doesn't make a phenomenal sound, but it doesn't make a bad sound either. It's a nice little purr, kind of like, you know, when you scratch a kitten, or the purring sound that a cat makes, but not like the full-on roar of a lion. Since we're back here, I'll go ahead and pop this trunk really quick. Take a look. There's a good bit of room. This is a smaller compact in the luxury class. Here I am in the back seat, as always. So now you can see this seat right now, we've got adjusted for someone about 5'10". 6 foot tall-ish, somewhere in that range. And there's a good bit of room still. So they could actually come all the way back, and I'm about 5'9", and I'm comfortable back here. You know, headroom is starting to get a little close, and that's where you kind of lose, but a 6 foot person could actually just tilt their head down. It's not the worst. Back here, there's not a whole lot of amenities, but you do have rear vents, which is good, and it's expected on a luxury car. You also get these cool pop-out cup holders, and they are adjustable. So they'll fit everything from a small drink to a Magnum drink. The cool thing is if you ever need more cargo space, these seats do fold flat. And then another cool thing that I discovered is you can actually lock and unlock these seats. So if you want to make sure that they're not going to go anywhere, you can just lock them. I like that. As always, let's talk about some numbers. This motor makes 204 horsepower, 185 foot-pounds of torque. It weighs about 3,500 pounds and gets about 30 miles per gallon on the highway 21 city. The only option for a transmission is a 6-speed automatic, but if you do opt for the 350, the IS350 that is, you get a whole lot more horsepower, 306. Some more numbers for you guys. It'll do 0 to 60 in about 7.7 seconds, which isn't bad, isn't great, but it also has the option to get rear-wheel drive or all-wheel drive, so that's a plus. If something sounds a little off to you guys, it might be because this is a 2.5 liter six-cylinder. So it's pretty big, but it's small at the same time. 2.5 is usually like a four-cylinder size. when you get to like the 3 liter and the 3.2, that's usually the V6 sizes. So it's kind of interesting, they've got a 2.5 liter V6. If you're ever on the lookout for any Toyota badging or anything, as you can see right there, it says Toyota right next to that Lexus badge. But if that ever matters to you, just remember that BMW owns Mini and Nissan owns Infiniti, or vice versa, and then Acura and Honda. So really, does it really matter? Let me get in a good seating position here to talk about this car. First thing, these seats, comfortable. Very, very nice. As much as I love these seats, the one thing that I have to complain about is just that they're not heated or cooled or ventilated. So it's kind of a downside, but for some people, they don't care about that and it's not really a big deal at all. You can find these with that option. This specific one just does not have it. You do get some awesome things though, like dual climate control, and this air conditioning works really, really nice. You do get a push start, you do get a great transmission, you get these cool controls and a snow mode, which I'll tell you about that in a little bit. You've got a sunroof. So normally you have one button for your sunroof that controls the up, down, side to side motions, but Lexus decided to do one button for the up and down and then the other one for fully open and close. I feel like you could have done that with one button. Another cool thing is adjustable seat belts. I like this because sometimes your seat belt's cutting your circulation off and trying to kill you. I find it interesting how Lexus does their layout, because you've got this little screen down here, but then if you look up top, you've got another screen, and it's kind of like they kept the old styling with the new styling and they met somewhere in between. Lexus does include a fancy clock, so you know that you're in a luxury car. I don't know if you guys can see this on the camera, but it's got these little touch sensitive strips right here. So you just basically slide up and down. Let me see if I can get my hand out of the way. And you can see it reads your finger input. I don't know if I love it or I hate it, but I think it's kind of cool, but just something to point out to you guys. Just to give you guys a demonstration of what the infotainment system looks like. The steering wheel setup is nothing crazy, nothing too fancy, but you do have your hands-free, you know, options that are there, like your dialing and your voice controls. You even get the option to have paddle shifters, which I do like. Automatic daytime running lights, automatic headlights, all of that good stuff. Wiper blade controls, cruise control, it's all there. I'm really upset that Lexus didn't just remove these buttons instead of leaving them blank. It's kind of a tease. If you're fortunate to have a garage, Lexus has you covered because you do get a garage door opener with a compass. Since this is a 2.5 liter, it does get good gas mileage. You can put it in eco mode. And then if you really want to be aggressive, throw it in sport. Move your eyes down here and you'll see that snow button I was talking about earlier. What that does, it's a Toyota Lexus feature. And basically you push that button and it allows you to start the car in like second gear, which cuts back on the slipping in the snow and all that good stuff. And it basically just sets the car up for better handling in a snowy situation. And that's always a plus. Overall, this is a pretty nice interior to be in. And it's time to take this thing for a drive. In the short time that I've spent with this IS250, it's been pretty pleasurable, not in a weird way, but I've enjoyed it. It's very similar to a lot of the German cars in the comfort. The road noise is really good, or I should say on the quiet side, which is expected from a luxury brand. The materials feel good. Transmission shifts pretty good. It's not spectacular. It's not a dual clutch, but it is pretty good for an automatic. The paddle shifters are nice. If you're, you know, ever going to race someone or do some spirited driving, you would definitely want to take advantage of those. Suspension feels pretty good. Putting it in sport, I wouldn't say that there's a huge difference, but it feels a little bit more peppy. And then putting it in eco, it's definitely softer and squishier. So I would say normal mode is your best bet, unless you're really doing some fun driving, but this car can handle all that. It's got just enough power for a daily car and it feels all right. I wouldn't go getting the F Sport just because the F Sport's really just a cosmetic thing and it's just for the looks, but this has fairly good looks as well. Lexus has come a long way in making their brand more sporty and appealing to younger buyers, whereas the old Lexus used to be just like your grandpa's car, your grandma's car. This isn't that anymore. Overall, it drives well, it's reliable. This is, after all, a Toyota underneath all of these awesome Lexus fancy shiny things, which means that you're gonna have that reliability, and that's worth a lot, especially compared to like an Audi or a Mercedes. This is the better bang for your buck, especially if you're a, you know, DIY type of mechanic and you just do a lot of work on your own. This is a lot easier to work on than those German cars. But I don't really have a whole lot to say on the driving experience. It gets you from A to B very comfortably. It's a very fun car. It's reliable, it's sporty enough, and honestly, for the price that you can get one of these, it's kind of hard to beat. And without having to worry about the headaches and all those things and having to get a warranty because it's a Toyota, this car, it's definitely on the list of ones I would recommend. So thank you guys for checking out yet another episode of LJ's Garage. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. And be sure to give this a little thumbs up and stay tuned for the next episode.